make a decision. God can so transform me with this truth that no matter if I look to the right, left, behind me, in front of me, how destructive everything looks, if I
stay. Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ, and welcome to this morning's service as we give God thanks and praise for His glorious new day of life. We begin our service with the hymn, Walls Are Tumbling.
See what the Lord has done for us. See what the mighty God is.
Tumbling.
Can't not get a witness.
The walls are tumbling
down, so let's pray this holy. Here we go.
God's gonna disassociate you from the pain. God's gonna disassociate you from the problem. God's gonna disassociate you from your past. Tell somebody.
See it.
The walls are tumbling.
I can feel it. The walls are tumbling down. So let's breathe this holy name.
His mercy is gonna visit you. His truth is gonna transform you. Hey, you better give God some praise. Y'all better help me out. Get up here, DJ.
Continue our service on page 33 in our books of common prayer with the opening sentence for Epiphany, and we continue with the sentences thereafter. Far from the rising of the sun to its setting, my name is great among nations, and in every place incense is offered in my name, and a pure offering, for my name is great among the nation, says the Lord of hosts. Blessed be the Lord our God, by whose grace we are yet alive. Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ, by whose rising we are set free. Blessed be the Spirit of God, in whom is our hope and our joy. Together. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship be a witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. Jubilati. O shout to the Lord in triumph, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his face with songs of joy. Know that he is God. It is he who has made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Come into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him, and bless his holy name. For the Lord is good, and his loving mercy is forever, his faithfulness throughout all generations. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. We come now to the moment where we get the opportunity to offer our sins and our misdoings, our misdeeds to God. And we ask that we be penitent with our hearts as we give God the honor and glory and ask him to forgive us of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life, which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Psalms appointed for today are Psalms 5 and 6. Psalms 5 and 6.
Psalm 5. Give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my meditation. Hearken to my cry for help, my King and my God, for I make my prayer to you. In the morning, Lord, you hear my voice. Early in the morning, I make my appeal and watch for you. For you are not a God who takes pleasure in wickedness, and evil cannot dwell with you. Braggarts cannot stand in your sight. You hate all those who work wickedness. You destroy those who speak lies. The bloodthirsty and deceitful, O Lord, you abhor. But as for me, through the greatness of your mercy, I will go into your house. I will bow down towards your holy temple in awe of you. Lead me, O Lord, in your righteousness, because of those who lie in wait for me. Make your way straight before me, for there is no truth in their mouth. There is destruction in their heart. Their throat is an open grave. They flatter with their tongue. Declare them guilty, O God. Let them fall because of their schemes. Because of their many transgressions, cast them out, for they have rebelled against you. But all who take refuge in you will be glad. They will sing out their joy forever. You will shelter them, so that those who love your name may exult in you. For you, O Lord, will bless the righteous. You will defend them with your favor as with a shield. Psalm 6. Lord, do not rebuke me in your anger. Do not punish me in your wrath. Have pity on me, Lord, for I am weak. Heal me, Lord, for my bones are racked. My spirit shakes with terror. How long, O Lord, how long? Turn, O Lord, and deliver me. Save me for your mercy's sake. For in that, no one remembers you. And who will give you thanks in the grave? I grow weary because of my groaning. Every night I drenched my bed and flood my couch with tears. My eyes are wasted with grief and worn away because of all my enemies. Depart from me, all evildoers, for the Lord has heard the sound of my weeping. The Lord has heard my supplication. The Lord accepts my prayer. All my enemies shall be confounded and quake with fear. They shall turn back and suddenly be put to shame.
The first lesson is taken from Ephesians chapter 1, verses 15 to 23. Ephesians chapter 1, verses 15 to 23.
Ephesians chapter 1, verses 15 to 23. For this reason, ever since I heard about your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love for all God's people, I have not stopped giving thanks for you, remembering you in my prayers. I keep asking that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Father, may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation so that you may know him better. I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which he has called you, the riches of his glorious inheritance in his holy people, and his incomparably great power for us who believe. That power is the same as a mighty strength he exerted when he raised Christ from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly realms, far above all rule and authority, power and dominion, and every name that is invoked, not only in the present age, but also in the one to come. And God placed all things under his feet and appointed him to be head over everything for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills everything in every way. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Benedictus. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You have raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of your servant David. Through your holy prophets, you promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our forebears, and to remember your holy covenant. This was your oath you swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship you without fear, holy and righteous before you, all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High. For you will go before the Lord to prepare the way, to give God's people knowledge of salvation, by the forgiveness of their sins and the tender compassion of our God. The dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine upon those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. The second reading is taken from the Gospel of Marc, chapter 1, verses 14 to 28.
Marc, chapter 1, verses 14 to 28. Now after John was arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaiming the good news of God, and saying, "The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." As Jesus passed along the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you fish for people." And immediately they left their nets and followed him. As he went a little farther, he saw James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, who were in their boat mending the nets. Immediately he called them, and they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired men and followed him. They went to Capernaum, and when the Sabbath came, he entered the synagogue and taught. They were astounded at his teaching, for he taught them as one having authority and not as the scribes. Just then there was in their synagogue a man with an unclean spirit, and he cried out, "What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." But Jesus rebuked him, saying, "Be silent and come out of him." And the unclean spirit, convulsing him and crying with a loud voice, came out of him. They were all amazed And they kept on asking one another, "What is this? A new teaching with authority? He commands even the unclean spirits and they obey him." At once, his fame began to spread throughout the surrounding region of Galilee. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
My dear friends in Christ, I thank you for joining us once again as we celebrate another day of life. This morning we'll be chatting on Mark chapter 1, verses 14 to 28. And I ask God's guidance as he uses me as his vessel and he speaks through me. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. As Jesus passed along the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I'll make you fish for people." Dear friends in Christ, as a Christian, we are called. We are all called by God. We are all called by God to serve various purposes, various missions. In this particular situation here, we have the calling of the first disciples. We see Simon, who is also known as Peter, and his brother Andrew. They were on their daily duties, their jobs, which they were fishermen. And something about Jesus telling them to follow him, something about this person, this man, as far as they would have seen, was worth them following. That they immediately gave up their nets and they followed Jesus. What eventually led to this would have been approximately 3 years of learning from Jesus as he visited various parts and regions proclaiming the good news of God. We here also have to remember that we too are called to be disciples of God. We too are called to follow Jesus' word and sacraments. We too are called to answer the call to serve our God through our brothers and sisters in Christ. But what we have to do is we can take some examples from this passage here where Jesus called the first disciples. We too are given that call. Jesus recognizes us for our talents or on what it is that we can do and the gifts that God has given to us. And when we are given these gifts, God knows that we are given them to serve him, to serve his kingdom, to serve his people. In Ephesians, we understand the various gifts of the Holy Spirit that are given to us. We are also given talents and opportunities, these things which God has given us to use in the church. Some of the popular talents we may see, someone preaching, someone in the choir, someone cleaning the church, someone ushering, and these things are the popular things that we see. But there's a lot of work that has to be done in the background. The church needs people of all needs and talents. God is calling you, the accountants, the lawyers, or the people who can market, the photographers, all of us. God is calling us to pack, to give. And these are the things that God calls us to do. And like the disciples, God expects us to be disciplined and to follow any words that he has called us to be. in our Christian journey, we and ourselves would experience growth. And the call for us will be different according to the stage of our lives and where we are. We are called to be God's people, but we are not called to be one place all the time. The disciples, as you would have seen, God would have bestowed upon them different roles and responsibilities, different tasks to complete, because God knew where they were. Jesus trained his disciples and he guided them. Similarly, over our journey of our Christianity, God will continue to train us. He will continue to guide us. We are not meant to stay one place in our entire lives, but rather we are expected to grow. And now that we continue to grow in Christ, we have to remember that God may be calling us to further service. Yes, God may be calling you to be a server. God may be calling you to be a lay minister. God may be calling you to the ordained ministry. But that decision and that call is between you and God. God will speak to you in your dreams. He will speak to us in many people, because unlike in those days, Jesus Christ is not physically here with us that we can see. But God still speaks to us through the power of the Holy Spirit. And that Holy Spirit speaks to us every day. Go left, go right, do this, do not do that. Speak to him, speak to her. Stay away from that situation. God doesn't want you there. And these are the ways God continues to speak to us. Similarly, he speaks to us as he continues to say things such as, my son, my daughter, follow me. Let me guide you. I have these things, these goals for you. Follow me. Let me make you a fisher of men in your own way, in your own light. Because quite too often, many of us want to follow the person to whom we see. The person who we see and we want to emulate and be just like him or her. But God didn't call us to imitate our priest. God didn't tell us to be just like the choir mistress. God called us to be individuals, but rather to serve him and be fishers of men by listening to his call for us. So we need to be ourselves. We need to be that person whom God created. But even better, we need to be better versions than ourselves by being one with God. We have to recognize the power of God in our lives. And we cannot deny ourselves or deny the gifts that God gave us. But rather, we have to say to ourselves, I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to give God thanks and praise. I have to give God thanks for everything that he did for me in my life, the good and the bad. Because in following Jesus, we are not going to say we are going to only have smooth days. We are going to have trials. We are going to have tribulations. We are going to have stresses. We are going to have days when we ourselves may doubt why it is we chose this mission. But we are guaranteed that we must give God thanks and praise for everything, as mentioned in our reading today in Ephesians. We have to give God thanks, because it's through the trials we become stronger. Through the tribulations, we triumph. Through the struggles, we know what we can endure. And through, my dear friends in Christ, our testimonies to God, we win people in Christ. So let us say yes to follow Jesus today. For we have decided to follow Jesus. Are you going to turn back, or are we going forth to march in the way of the Lord? In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Today, in our intercessions, we remember the Most Reverend Howard Gregory, Archbishop of the Province of the West Indies. In our own diocese, we remember the Right Reverend Claude Berkeley, Diocesan Bishop of Trinidad and Tobago, and remember all retired bishops as well at this point in time. In our diocesan cycle of prayer, we remember and pray for the parish of St. Augustine in Labrie. We pray for the Reverend Margaret Barker Caesar and the Reverend Donald Gopal, who are stewards in that part of God's vineyard. We also remember Faisabad Anglican Secondary School at this point in time. We remember in our own parish, the Reverend Dr. Anderson Maxwell, parish priest. We remember the Reverend Father Titus Akbarali, assistant curate. And we remember all deacons, the Reverend Rodwin Fanfare, Reverend Daniel Pontiflet Andre, and the Reverend Theodore Finley. We pray God will continue to bless all of God's ministers as he continues to lift them up, that he will give them strength and give their families that support and blessing as well. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let us pray. We use intercession form E, the suffrages form E. Lord, reveal your love among us, that we may know the joy of your salvation. Grant peace within and among all nations, and teach our leaders wisdom. Endow your church with faithfulness, and her servants with knowledge and true godliness. Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed, that your justice may be known among all people. Lord, renew your spirit within us, that in us and through us your will may be done. The Collect, found on page 160, the first Sunday after Epiphany. Father in heaven, who at the baptism of Jesus in the River Jordan proclaimed him your beloved Son and anointed him with the Holy Spirit, grant that all who are baptized into his holy name may keep the covenant they made and boldly confess him as Lord and Savior, and with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, in glory everlasting. Amen. Now, I would like us to remember in our notices all those who would have passed at this point in time. We are still in need for electronic devices for students of our various schools. We ask that you give generously. You can message us. You can call our office at 640-4429, or you can email us at stmarystacrigo@gmail.com, so you can find out and how you can make your donations to us and get these devices to the children who are in need. We would like to say a very special happy birthday to a number of our parishioners, to Jadon Kojo, whose birthday was January 1st, to Jennifer Samson Farrell, whose birthday was Saturday, to Nicole Naomi Solomon, whose birthday was Sunday, to Gail Duke, whose birthday was yesterday, and to those whose birthdays are coming up during this week, Patricia Lenora Bartholomew, to Mervyn Stout, to Shafina Govia, to Michael Phillip, to Brian Wilshire, to Peter Moore, to Emmeline Olive Arthur, and Daniel Guy. We pray God's grace upon them as we continue in God's mercy. The prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons with the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. Amen. My dear friends in Christ, the Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Have a blessed day, a blessed week, and let us remember to answer the call of God as we become fishers of men. Amen. Jesus Christ is son.